Zippo is one of the most famous brand names in the United States. The company has been producing lighters in Bradford, Pennsylvania for 80 years. And on June 5th, the 500 millionth Zippo will roll off the line.
Channel 4 Action News anchor Sally Wiegand was just in Bradford for a behind-the-scenes tour.
It was the light from home for our soldiers in World War II. It lit up the screen in films like Bridge on the River Kwai and The Birds. And it has lit up encores for millions of rock concert goers.
Plating material. Yeah.
And the windproof lighter nearing its 500 millionth milestone starts right here.
Here's a stainless steel material with some brass. We use a couple different compositions of metal, but for the most part, the process has not changed in the history of the company.
What is this? A process that is elegantly simple, a combination of automation and skilled hands.
Then you just put your inside in. It's a fit. Pull it forward and make sure you hear the Zippo click.
This basic popular model now costs under $15, up from $1.95 when its founder, George Blaisdell, created it in 1932.
He was probably fortunate if he built 20 lighters in a day. Now, today we're building between 60 and 70,000 lighters a day. And so the company has come so far.
Mr. Duke, grandson of George Blaisdell, has diversified, buying a local knife company, another lighter company, and starting an outdoor gear segment. The overseas segment of Zippo lighter sales is now 60%, with China and India growth markets. But Duke is quick to point out Zippo does not promote smoking.
When we're able to sell products to people who are not using our product necessarily for smoking, that's a wonderful thing.
And that is what has not changed from 1932, the devotion to making sure the Zippo works. It is why the 500 millionth celebration will fall on June 5th, Blaisdell's birthday, and why a replica of Blaisdell's office is in the Zippo Museum.
A fan was always placed in his office. If you came in, he'd greet you, he'd give you a big smile, he'd talk, and then he'd say, "Let's do the fan test."
Then I tried a different kind of wind test with Mr. Duke Zippo's. We had one more test. Zippo swears by its lighter's resilience, so we brought in an old lighter to see how they did with it.
There
it is. There it is. Let's see if it still works. Blow. Don't burn me. All right, that's it. This is, by the way, this belongs to Jim Spence, remember?
Right.
His Navy CB son gave him this 10 years ago, so we're going to give that back to him.
All right,
this is for you, guys. This is an 80th anniversary lighter. I don't know who gets it, so you fight over that. This is the most reproduced image on a Zippo lighter. It's the Statue of Liberty. It's mine.
Oh!
and wait a minute. We have something for you. Mike Harvey, these are the hand warmers. This is their outdoor gear line. Mm. They want you to do the weather outside and use these, okay?
Okay,
so that's
done.
For Mike. All right.
Done.
And we're done. And by the way, you can customize your own lighter now on the Zippo website, and we have a link to that on, of course, as seen on WTAE.
Picture
nice.
Sally Wiegand is going to be on
there. There you go. She's on T-shirts already. You know,
by the way, most Zippo lighters are 2.2 inches long. 500 million of them, laid end-to-end, would stretch from Pittsburgh to Bangkok, Thailand, and then back again.
Very cool.